Hello dear friends, welcome to Shiksha Mantra. And today in Shiksha Mantra, the topic we have chosen, you have already found it out in the thumbnail. Don't learn degrees of comparison before you watch this discussion. Yes dear friends, that's the topic we have chosen today. So we are going to discuss about degrees of comparison. That's sure, it has been written there. In the title as well. But why this discussion is so very important to watch before you learn degrees of comparison? So this is our discussion. This is why it's so very important to watch this video till the end. You have to understand each and every point I'm going to discuss here. So let's begin our discussion here in Shiksha Mantra right now. Yes, dear friends, most of the times what happens when we consider of degrees of comparison, the first thing that strikes us is the form, good, better, best, pretty, prettier, prettiest. So the addition of ear or est and the addition of more and most, that strikes us the most. So what we do, let's write it down and find out in the blackboard what we have here to mean. So what we do? Whenever we consider degrees of comparison, it provides us the sense of the formation. But formation of what? Not the formation of adverb and adjectives. There we get confused. Most of the time we remain busy with the ER or EST, superlative and comparative and superlative forms of degrees of comparison. But the formation, when I say formation, what I mean? When I say formation, I mean the sentence, the construction of the sentences. Yes, dear friends, this is what most of the time we miss. Why to learn these forms of positive, comparative or superlatives? Because we have to use them in a sentence, na? So whenever you are going to learn something in English grammar, you have to remember one simple point. You are learning this to use it in a sentence. So formation of the sentence is your ultimate goal. Be it grammar, be it vocabulary or something else, whatever component of the language you are learning, your sole aim is to use them in your own sentences. So the formation of the sentences of degrees comparison is so very important. And here I'm going to discuss a very typical point. And again, let me be clear one thing. I'm not going to drag this discussion long because there's nothing to discuss about it so longer. When we consider the formation of sentences, we put much importance on the comparative degrees and the superlative degrees. These are the causes of our concern always. We are very much concerned about formation of comparative and superlative, but where we lack? We lack the formation of the positive degree. Yes, dear friends, I am writing it down in bold. Positive degree. Most of the time, we don't consider positive degree seriously. It is as if formation of positive doesn't have anything in it. It's very simple. But tell me one single point. When you have to transform sentences from comparative or superlative to positive degree, don't you need the formation of positive degree? There, the knowledge of the formation of positive degree is so very important that without this, you cannot transform the sentences. As comparative and superlative have different forms, we put much importance to them. But the positive doesn't have any special form. It's the common form that we use. It doesn't mean the formation of the sentences in positive degree doesn't need our considerations. It's also a serious construction, and that serious construction must be learned seriously. So here we are going to learn the formation of positive degree first. So let's wipe out the board and start our discussion of the formation of positive degree. So let's wipe out positive degree. Yes, dear friends, here we are to discuss the formation of positive degree. But how the positive degree is formed, we are going to have that discussion. But before we start the discussion of it, I must tell you one thing very clearly, and for this I have to write two sentences. So let's write the sentence first. He is a good boy. Now, if you look at this sentence, he is a good boy. What's there? He is a good boy. So here, the adjective is written in positive degree. This is the positive form of the adjective. So it's in positive degree. But is there any comparison? No comparison is there. But can you tell me one thing? If we use comparison in positive degree, do we really use any comparison in positive degree? You'd say no, sir. Positive degree is not for comparison. So we don't use any comparison in positive degree. That would be your answer. But believe me, dear friends, it's not true. We use comparison in positive degree. That's why when we consider the formation of positive degree, we must remember that positive degrees can be formed with two alternatives. First is with comparison, and the second is without comparison, or it's better to write down without comparison first. Without comparison, and the second is with comparison. We'll discuss about what is with comparison, what is without comparison, but I can assure you one thing. You won't find it any in book. You won't find it anywhere. You won't find it in any book. But this is very vital. We don't consider it most of the time. That's why I have said, don't learn degrees of comparison before you watch this discussion, before you watch this video. So what is without comparative and what is with comparative? If you look at this sentence, the first sentence, what we have done here. He is a good boy. Here, good. This is used. But without comparison. There's no comparison. There's only one noun present. He. And good boy, this boy is but he itself. So no comparison is made here. But when we produce a sentence like this, he is as good as his brother. Now look at this sentence. He is as good as his brother. What we have done here? Here good. This is also the same adjective in positive degree. And before that we have used as, after that we have used as, and there's a noun, there's another noun. So here in this sentence a comparison is made. A comparison between these two components, he and his brother. So two nouns are here. And these two nouns are set side by side for a comparison. Now here you may say, sir, there's also another noun boy. This is also a noun. But he and the boy, their identity were the same. But here the two nouns we have used, they belong to different identity. That's why the comparison is there. That's why we have said it's with comparison. The first one was without comparison, but the second one is with comparison. So how do we form positive degree with comparison? The point is very simple. Just follow what I am writing here, because for following this construction, you'll get it very easy. The first point is we use the adjective, and that's also in positive form. So adjective in positive degree, that's we use here. And now after this we use as, before this we use as. So these two as, they are the key for the formation of positive degree with comparison. As adjective in positive degree, and it's framed within as, and after the as we use a noun, before the as we use a noun. So that is the construction. If you look at this structure, you'll very easily understand this. This is the construction we use here. As plus adjective as. So noun, then as, then adjective in positive degree, then as, and then another noun. So this is how the comparison in positive degree goes. Yes, dear friends, I am telling very clearly and very slowly so that you may follow it properly. Here we have used positive degree with comparison. Now the question appears. One day I was teaching this to my students. When a student says, sir, there's the verb and you haven't told anything regarding the verb is. Yes, dear friends, that's also a very vital point. That's also a very vital point, but I haven't discussed it so far. Now we are discussing about the verb. So here the noun accepts a verb and it goes with the rules of subject verb conjugation. So I am not going after the verb. It follows the normal ways of subject verb comparison. But here when I say he is as good as his brother, there's no verb after his brother. Is there a verb or there isn't? Obviously, dear friends, there is also a verb. Actually, the verb is here. He is as good as his brother is. Just look at the board. This is remains understood. We don't use this is in the sentence. But it doesn't mean the verb is there. The verb is obviously there. Here also we have another verb for this noun. But the problem is, realize the problem. The problem is whenever we consider this, it becomes what? It becomes a complex sentence. So dear friends, this is another very vital point that you have to remember. A positive degree can be both simple and complex. When it is used without comparison, it's simple. But when it is used with comparison, it becomes complex. And again, it can be as well. He is so good at it, like his brother or as his brother. So we can use as is construction, and at the same time we may use so as construction as well. So this is what we have about positive degree. Now let's begin our discussion about comparative. Yes, dear friends, about comparatives, it's very easy, it's very simple. I'm not going to have a long discussion regarding comparative degree, because it's available in each and every book. You have to remember one point that I'm here to clarify, that you have to learn the formation of comparative degrees, formation of each and every degree well. So what's there in comparative degree? Obviously, there's a comparison. We have produced a sentence there. He is as good as his brother. Now we may produce the same sentence here in comparative degree. He is better, though this is not properly produced. I must have written he is not better. I am skipping not here. He is better than his brother. So if you look at this sentence, he is better than his brother. What we get here? We get better. This is adjective in comparative form. Then comes than, and here's the noun. Here's the noun. There's also the verb, and the same thing here as well. There's also the verb. So this is the construction we follow for comparative degrees. But there we make the mistake. For every time, I've told you, I'm going to discuss only the key factors, the key features of degrees of comparison, not everything, what is written everywhere in any book. My point is to provide you the tricks of the degrees of comparison. So what comes here? You must remember it's not always than, sometimes it's two as well. He is senior to his brother. You can't say he is senior than his brother. So here you have to remember those words, those degrees, those adjectives in comparatives: senior, junior, superior, ulterior, exterior, interior. All these, you have your list, you'd get the list everywhere in every book. So just prepare the list well. Most of the time I have found my students making mistakes in it. Not my students only, but every students. They forget about two and they use than because they are used to. They are used to in using than. So they forget to consider whether it would be two or than, and they use two. They use than in place of two. So here you have to stay cautious for the formation of comparative degrees. And then comes what? Then comes superlative degree. And before we start the discussion of superlative degree, let's wipe the board out. So the board has been wiped out, and now it's time for us to shift to where? To shift to superlative degree. Yes, dear friends, when we consider superlative degrees, it's super, it's number one. And when we consider the number one position, the topmost position, one thing that hits us that it's definite. So superlative degree is introduced with the how? Let's have a sentence here. He is the best boy of the class. So he is the best boy of the class. Whenever we say this, here obviously we have used the adjective, and that's in superlative degree. And before that you have to use the mandatorily, and of this construction. So here adjective, the superlative adjective is within a framework, that is the of. Just consider, every time we put degrees of comparison, we put them in a framework. For positive degree, the framework is as or so as, and beside that framework also we have to consider the nouns. And for the comparative degree, the framework is provided by than, and here in the superlative degree, the framework is provided by the and of. So whenever you are in degrees of comparison, your focus must be, I'm repeating, your focus must be on the formation of comparative and superlative and positive degree, and the formation not in terms of adjectives but in terms of the sentences as well. So, now you are ready to fly free, to learn the degrees of comparison. The sky of the degrees of comparison is free. It's yours now. So, let's conclude our discussion here and start your discussion of degrees of comparison, because you have already learned the most important points and the key features of degrees of comparison. So let's sign off here right now. We are returning very soon. Until then, bye bye. Happy learning.